Got some mail for you, Paps.
What's wrong, Pap? Pap? Are you okay?
Dad! Pap's crying!
What's wrong, Pap? Please, why are you crying? Dear Hank, I am sorry to have to write you this letter. I'm sorry to tell you that Jesse has passed away. It was very sudden. I apologize for not telling you sooner or having you at the funeral. With all of the confusion, I simply forgot you were still around. I am so sorry, Pap. Jesse, who was Jesse?
He was my best friend. He was our corpsman in Korea. He was my best man when I married your grandmother.
Okay, I remember him. He had the horses I liked to ride when I was a kid.
Yeah, that was him. We were the best of friends. Especially since he saved my life.
He saved your life? How? What happened?
Come on. I'll let you know about Jesse and a few other men I knew. I joined the Marine Corps right out of high school. World War II had been over for some years. When we heard about tension in a place called Korea. Hell, we didn't even know where this place Korea was. One day, I'm happy and having fun on the beaches of Cali, and the next thing I know, I'm on a ship headed for Korea. We landed at Busan. Well, after a few days, we encountered our first fight. It was someplace called Chindong-ni. Well, we thought it would last forever. The fighting was terrible, fierce. We fought for nearly 2 weeks. The North Koreans finally retreated. Most of us had never seen combat before and was glad that the fight was over. We knew this was only the beginning. A few weeks later, we were at Incheon. Oh, we surprised those bastards good. In less than a week, we had cleared the area, started a door-to-door campaign in Seoul, the South Korean capital, to clear those commie North Koreans out of there. We lost a couple guys, but we had a job to do, so we moved on.
Must have been pretty scary. Were you scared?
Oh, we were scared, all right. But we were Marines. We took that fear and turned it on the commie bastards. But the worst was yet to come.
I read stories about Incheon and Chosin Reservoir in college. They said that was the worst of the action.
The first year was the toughest. After that, it calmed down a little bit. Chosin was a bitch, though. Mountainous area, biting cold. Many of us got frostbite, but were killed. I think we lost around 4,000. But the commie bastards took heavy losses. Even though we had to pull out. We still took over 20,000 of them. Luckily, none of my buddies got hurt bad. Brian, Sergeant Webster, He got a bronze star for his actions there. Willie Cole got a silver star.
That was a lot of people killed. Did you get any of those star things? Did you have to...
Misty, don't.
Did you have to kill anyone?
So it's all right, Sam. Yes, Misty, I did. Everyone had to do things they normally wouldn't. It was either shoot them or be killed yourself. It was a war. Although our politicians and others still want to call it a police action. A police action! We weren't police! We didn't go and arrest anyone! We were at war! Sorry, honey. Yes, but we didn't have a choice. We were there to help out the people of South Korea, so we did what had to be done. Over the next year, we spent a lot of time with other United Nations forces and in the army, pushing northward and westward. Although we did spend a lot of time around the Punch Bowl.
Punch Bowl? What was the Punch Bowl?
Oh, that was a valley in the mountains. It was where we hunkered down while the politicians and others with no brains started peace talks with the North. You realize that still today there's no formal declaration ending that war? It's still just a ceasefire. It never ended. The way that little midget who runs the North now keeps acting, I'm surprised we haven't been called back in.
I hope not. It's bad enough we have to be in Iraq and Afghanistan, and Iran keeps acting like they want to fight. So I hope we don't have to do any more wars.
I know what you mean, honey. I was in Iraq back in Desert Storm. I feel for the people fighting these wars now. I feel for you too, Pap, and all the men and women who have ever had to put on a uniform and fight.
Thanks, Sam. You know, I can't tell you who half our neighbors are, but I can remember most of the guys I was with over there. Jesse was definitely one of them.
You said he saved your life. When was that? What did he do?
A week before we left Korea, we came under attack with some heavy fighting. Since we had fought at Incheon, none of us had been hurt too bad. A couple shots in the arms or legs. Nothing too serious, although they did give us purple hearts for getting shot. Well, we were holding our own when I saw Brian go down. I called for Jesse, our corpsman, Jesse Reagan, and the army calls them medics, to go check on Brian. I was just getting ready to get up as Jesse was coming in front of me when Jesse spun and went down. He'd been shot. Well, luckily, it was in his leg. I swear that bullet was meant for me from where it hit Jesse. We've been friends, but from then on, he and I were best of friends. I never could thank him enough, even though he didn't really do anything but being in that spot at that time. After the war, Jesse was my best man when I married Sally. The love of my life. She was my high school sweetheart, the best woman I ever knew. I was even the best man at his wedding. He moved a couple years ago out to Virginia to live with his daughter Marge and her family. It's been about a year since we talked. I'll miss you, Jesse. Rest in peace, brother. He was the last beside me. Jimmy Hayes, Will Cole died in Vietnam. I heard Corporal Hanks died about 1993 in a car wreck. James Moore and PFC Wright, they died a few years ago. Well, there are a few more that I remember a little, but they either died in Vietnam or within the last couple of years. Of those that I'd formed a bond with, Jesse was the last to go. They say friends come and go, but I'll tell you this much. Those friends that you make in war, they are always there. No matter what, they will be there for you. I just wish I could have been there for you, Jesse. I'll see you soon, my brother. My friend. Oh.